Oh, don't show the mouse. Stupid thing. Yeah, I'm just gonna let this, oh, I can't make it not show the mouse. Quality. Oh. I'll just let the story scroll. This is obviously the first time this has been attempted to be streamed on this channel. What bitrate are we uploading at? Just 1,000? Whatever. Go to live. That looks fine. Hey, Ashley. And hey, son. Right, yeah, this bitrate should be fine for this particular game. Hey, you gamer. Am I familiar with a bit of Brawl in the Family? Yes, if so. Obviously, since I know the acronym. Hey, Sorten. For some reason, the intro and the map screen seem to not run at full speed, but everything else does. The bad thing about Higan, which is apparently the same thing as BSNES, it only uses one core. So even at 4.5 gigahertz, it still has some minor issues. Yoshi's Island was the first video game I owned too, along with Donkey Kong Country. I always liked it better though. Did you notice the store was violently rocking the bags with the babies inside? Hey, he's supposed to deliver a baby. You know, insurance covers the rest. He's doing his job, they're doing theirs. Is the song supposed to be this slow at this point? Maybe it is. I'm not dropping frames in BSNES. Oh, he's Mario! He doesn't take fall damage. It's funny how the super advanced 3D graphics are kind of the one part of the game that doesn't look absolutely fabulous. Toys R Us just listed the Switch. Yeah, a few places have done that. I think Game, that one website that everybody hates in England. It's like the not Japanese, the British GameStop, but even worse. I think it's called Game UK. For some reason, Higan erased my controller bindings entirely. I don't really like Higan, and I think I may need to not use it. I think SNES 9X is basically close enough for most purposes. Oh, go away, mouse cursor. I keep forgetting that it still shows in this thing. With the little faces on the flowers. They're listening in, look at them. Yeah, this is Higan. Whatever, however you pronounce it. This paradise is Yoshi's Island, where all the Yoshis live. They're all in an uproar over the baby that fell from the sky. Reasonable. It's Master Higgins, sir. Wait, the baby seems to know where he wants to go. The bond between the twins informs each other of where the other one is. The Yoshis decide to carry the baby to his destination via a relay system. Now begins the adventure for the Yoshis and baby Mario. Like the little itch in his chin animation. He's just thinking about it. He's like, If Baby Mario falls off Yoshi's back, the countdown timer will begin. It reaches zero. Yeah, it's basically your health. So you have 10 seconds to get Baby Mario back. This is actually a little tutorial stage that you'll never see again. You can't revisit this stage. Boop. Yeah. This just teaches you to flutter jump. Toys R Us Canada listed for 244. I'd be pretty surprised if it's that low. I don't know what they're doing. Listing it that early. Usually they have, like, an exorbitant price whenever they list pre-orders for stuff like that. I'm sure they'd just not honor it if it happened to be more expensive than that, though. So yeah, this is Yoshi's Island. I think most people are probably already quite aware of it. It's a really fantastic game from really every angle. I really love the painterly look. The backgrounds are great. The foregrounds in some of the stages, like the little animated thingy, really breathtaking back then. Still beautiful now. Oh, Higgin, please. If Higgin is really bad, Higgin is supposed to be the accurate one, but if it can't run at full speed, accuracy doesn't really matter very much. So I might switch over to SNES 9X if it's too issuey, this stream. But in my experience, it ran mostly okay in the actual stages. Oh, and I love, this is some really classic, palette cycled water in the background there. Yeah, this game actually does some stuff the SNES can't do on its own. It uses the Super FX chip, which I believe is the same thing that Star Fox uses. It doesn't use it to the same goal, but it does it for lots of scaling and stuff the SNES isn't natively capable of. I think the NES had some carts that had onboard hardware as well, so games like that would be a bit more expensive, and they would do some things that the hardware itself, the console hardware, isn't quite capable of. It's also why this game and Star Fox are probably not going to come to Virtual Console. Apparently there's some legal issues with emulating it, or, you know, with distributing it. And the company that made the Super FX chip is defunct, so I don't know. Intellectual property stuff is just a mess, let's put it that way. And I decided I would try and 100% this game. For the special stages, I might end up resorting to save states, but we're not going to worry about that at first. Yeah, the bonus levels in this game are pretty tough. I never beat them as a kid, which is why I'm planning to beat them now. But also why I'm planning to use the, planning to use save states for those levels only. But I'll just do a plain old playthrough and not even worry about getting 100%. Then after I beat the game, I'll go back and 100% levels and just do the bonus stages and stuff. So, we'll probably be streaming this all November, especially since the first week mysteriously disappeared! Getting lots of jumps and frames. I'm only dropping 5% of frames, which is pretty much what happens. I can try dropping. I guess the bitrate was okay at 1,000, didn't look too bad. But it's about all I can do. My internet service provider is gonna take a look at it, but I don't even know. It does seem related to the time that I stream, so I might just have to stream earlier, maybe? Which is an annoyance in and of itself. I think if you're running at full speed, you'll always get... it'll always land on one of the flowers, assuming you have enough flowers to hit that one. So yeah, 100%. Very satisfying sound. No, nothing else is connected to my internet. I've tried it. It's seriously, there's absolutely nothing it could possibly be at my end. I have very, very, very thoroughly checked it out. And if I had to check it out any more thoroughly, I would probably just never stream again. Whoop! Fun fact, those falling chomps are mirrored, and for some reason there is a full non-mirrored sprite for them. But either to save memory or something, they just use the mirrored face. It has this little shine on their face. For some reason, the later Yoshi games do not indicate which coins are red visually. In this game, they have a little red tint to them instead of a blue one.
That's right, Parker.
Oh. Thought that might be a red one. It's been a long time since I played this game. Completely. Oh, come on, Higgin. Yeah, I think we're gonna try SNES next night. The SNES 9X next stream. Yeah, Yoshi's Island DS kind of is a jerk in trying to make it harder to get 100% for no real... Like, it's not better that way, it's just... Though Yoshi's Island DS really isn't too bad. Not as good as this game, of course. You know, not as good as one of the best of all time, but it's really... Yoshi's New Island is the one that's really... Ugh. Yoshi's Island DS, I would still recommend giving a play. It and Yoshi's Woolly World, too. And Yoshi's Story is just such a different game, but it's still good. I really love this Horizon background here. Oops, I already got that. No! No! Oh! RIP 100%. Yeah, I'm really disappointed that Yoshi's New Island went for the frickin' 3D, because the... Yoshi's Island DS kind of tries to ape this style, and it doesn't achieve it. But this is still one of the best-looking games of all time, in my opinion. How a race is pacifistic and innocent, does the Yoshi's capable exist in such a dangerous place? I don't know about pacifistic. I mean, they do eat everything in sight and then, you know, throw the eaten thing to, you know, kill other things. So, I mean, they're pretty puff. It's tough. It's just the babby Yoshis that seem to have trouble defending themselves. Yoshi's a very dangerous creature in this game. A little... Cloud things. I love the I love all the backgrounds really, but I love the look of these caves. Excuse you. That sound effect for when you land is actually the reason I decided to try Higgin instead of ZSNES, because ZSNES. Oh dang it. Oh wait, I don't even need that one. That sound effect is wrong in ZSNES. Timing is one of the hardest things to get right in an emulator, so it's not really surprising. What are the chomp rocks exactly? They are rocks, and they look like chomps. Ugh, stop that. Yeah, you'll see me slamming lots of pillars, because there's lots of red coins hidden in those, and you can't otherwise see them. There's an item to see them. That's another thing, this game was... The first time I ever saw anything like where you could use items to like buff your in-game, like your gameplay. It was very unusual for Nintendo or really anything at the time. Ugh, stop that, Baby Mario. I blame you for my failings. It's all your fault. Maybe they're fossilized chomps. You don't know. This is the ultimate fate of a chomp. Become a little rock thing. Huh. Well, if the stuff skips too bad, but not bad enough to make me stop the video, I'll just upload my local copy and it won't have the issues. Not much else I can do. That's the wonderful thing about streaming. There's really, at a certain point, a lot of stuff I simply can't do anything about. That's why I kind of don't really like streaming very much. Wait, where'd the key go? Oh. Give key. Oh. Frick. Give. There you go. No, you can't make your own red coins. You can make your own stars. You can make normal coins, but those aren't really... there's no real reason to do that. If you get two ricochets, then egg turns yellow, then red, and the red ones drop... two stars. So the only real thing to do in this minigame is to let the balloon fill up and then give it to him, because he will always solve it extremely quickly. The problem is I'm not used to how big it is before it pops, unfortunately. I think it's getting... Okay. It's that big. But yeah, that minigame isn't really very feasible to do just by solving it as fast as possible, because he'll just keep tossing it back. You can get maybe a 50-50 chance if you send it back as fast as possible. But, it's just hot potato. You just toss it back and forth. Alright, if you do this... I like this. They sort of give an explanation for why there are these infinite spawning tubes. Because as long as there's eggs to give you, these little duders keep spawning. Let's keep going. Oh, it's like that you could eat those little things. They seem tasty because Yoshi licks his chops after getting one. I had a little bit of trouble getting that one as a kid. Wait a minute. There's a thing. It's supposed to be a thing somewhere. Ah, there you go. I knew it. There we go. A little bonus stage. The bonus stages with tons of coins always felt so much more rewarding than just, you know, here's a couple one-ups. Have fun. You get to collect all the coins, and the coins are delicious. This game was on 3DS, or was that like one of the Ambassador games? There is a Game Boy Advance version of this game, but it's significantly inferior, like... It's the same game gameplay-wise, but it has all of the problems that all of the other Game Boy remakes do. The colors are wrong, the aspect ratio is wrong, the music's wrong. I think I just barely missed the Ambassador program. I got my 3DS with Harvest Moon, and I only really got Harvest Moon and the 3DS because I wanted the cow plush, and it was worth it. Oh, did it have the squeak? Did it have the stupid toddler noises? I freaking hate that they just made that canon that Yoshi makes horrible toddler noises. That's another reason this is the best Yoshi game. It's the most petty reason, but it's still valid, damn it. I think some of these have... Ugh. Yeah, we're definitely playing on SNES 9X next time. Just sold the plush? Of course I do. I don't know if... Are there any settings I can use in Higen to make it... Ah, damn it. To make it a little bit faster without sacrificing anything? Probably not. Coins are just like Mario. They'll give you a 1-up if you get 100, which is why a lot of bonus things just give you over 100 coins. Yoshi's not silent in this version, but he makes like cute animal noises instead of horrible toddler noises. I don't know who could possibly listen to a toddler and be like, yeah, that's what I want to hear. I mean, it's pretty disturbing when you put it that way. Also, fire breath! Aw, gimme. Come on. So yeah, yellow eggs always give you some coins. More importantly, there's red eggs. And there's the flashing red eggs, which give you the red coins. That might have been what you were thinking about. Whoever mentioned, getting red coins. But now you can't get red coins at will. And I love the little fire, blargs. This game has my favorite blargs by far. The actual Mario ones, even though they came first, I don't like them as much. Well, Adan? Ah. Get the coin, there you go. There we go. And this is one of many enemies that I think we only see these once or twice in like the whole game. There's a lot of enemies and game-like play mechanics like this. Yoshi's Island is one of those games, kind of like Copy Kitty, where it almost every level has something unique to it, and I really appreciate that. It's really hard to do that for a game at this scale. Like, a lot of people call this game short, and I mean, it's not crazy long or anything, but, it's short because there's really no fluff. You know, everything's, whoop, you know, they have so much frickin', you know, interesting stuff going on. Your first experience with this game was waiting room and a dentist? I want to have your dentist. My dentist doesn't have Super Nintendo. My dentist doesn't even have regular Nintendo. Okay, so this is officially deepest Mario lore. Boop. I had the guide for this game too. I don't think I still have it. Aw, you gotta be kidding me! Whatever. The goal ring will mean I have enough things. I didn't expect to get 100% on every world anyway. Like, not first try. Aw, your dentist has fish? My dentist has nothing interesting. It's a filthy adult dentist. There's not really anything fun for the kiddos. So you're still on the baby side, Yoshi baby? Then get a load of this. Kamek's pretty sassy in this game. Also, this rainbow effect was really cool. And so was this. This was like, what? How is this physically possible? Oh, uh-oh. I need more eggs. Fortunately, he basically has no AI, he just hops around. The first two bosses... In fact, the final world boss, or the first world boss, is actually easier than this one, because he can't really hurt you. He can knock you into lava, but I've... Ah, no! Mario, please! Yoshi, please! What are you doing? Aw, frick. Okay, unfortunately, we can't really get through him. Aw, for Pete's sake. Well... Anyway... Yoshi, get your freaking butt up! Okay. Anyway... Welcome to DeviantArt. That was at least three fetishes I counted. Oh right, I forgot about that. You can butt stomp to make the flower give everything. I still blame Mario for that. I always thought the map was so freaking cool. gives you the little previews of all of the levels. Like Super Mario World's map, it's not ugly as far as world maps go, but it doesn't really give you the idea of what you'll be seeing. Oh, I love this level. First going left level. There's a few other levels where we go left. I literally never saw a video game where you went left before. Like before this, I had played Donkey Kong, I had played one of the Marios, and I had played Sonic. And going left was like, oh. There are very dangerous donut lifts in this stage. They'll fall shortly after you stand on them. Good old donut lifts. Sorry about the audio crackles. Well, I'll try SNES 9X after this. I think it's like a good mix of performance and accuracy. It's like better than ZSNES accuracy-wise, and Higgin just uses too much CPU. It uses enough CPU that like one of the best CPUs you can even get. Like, I have like a $300 CPU here, and it just there's just nothing you can do. I'm glad I remembered that this little lift thing is actually required to get that. Gimme. Imagine it being your job to just hold a coin in midair at all periods of the day. I feel so sorry for that dude. Unfortunately, there's not really too many auto-scrolls. There are a few. There's... I should be looking at the level names. There's some really good level names in this game. It's like the really long cave. Touch Fuzzy, Get Dizzy is impossible to forget. There's a few other really good ones. Bird the Bachelor wasn't wearing a diaper, totally not DeviantArt. But you still got inflation, deflation. Is deflation also a fetish? You've got nudity, you've got bash, you know, humiliation, you've got explosion. That's probably a fetish. I haven't seen it before, but I would definitely not be surprised. Boop. I love the little ones that hide in the tree in as flowers. And it's so weird that Paper Mario was the perfect place to bring back a lot of Yoshi's Island enemies. Like, it brought back the Amazy Daisy, or the Daisy things, you know, the flower thing I just ate back there. But didn't really bring that many. Alright, this is the part where you have to use the donut lift to get the thingies. Not like you think, though. When you say it like that, I'm thinking of, like, somebody with a fetish for economic deflation. Like, my buying power is lower than it was when I started, even though I have the same amount of money! Yes! Oh! So much good music in this game, too. Economic deflation. Unfortunately, the flip cards, yeah, there's a different minigame at the end of each world. Or wait, no, I think there's a few different ones. But I don't like the minigames on the first world. There's a... And that's why, because if you get the freaking K-Mix space, you instantly lose. If we get all 100s in a world, we get access to the minigame anytime we want, and that lets us stock up. There's a certain one, the Match 2 one. Makes it really easy to stock up on items really fast. Oh wait, I think I need to change my input to hasty. I'll do it later. Shy Guys on stilts. Haha! Cookies on dowels. Yeah, of course there's a secret up here. Also, if you haven't seen a speedrun for this game, it's really amazing. Also, I love this. They have a lot of little rooms like this to teach you different effects of things. So you get a coin from that one. Probably just get rid of the other ones. You get a red coin from that one. And this one just gives you stars. Oh. You get the point. I'll just keep that for now. And of course, there's items that give you more. I think red eggs just straight up gives you stars. We actually got one of those to give you stars things. Oh wait, no, we didn't. Because of the freaking K-Mex space. I hate that. I always get the freaking K-Mex space. Their feet are so bright. You didn't know you could switch between eggs? Oh yeah, you just have to use an egg and then press down, and then that egg goes back to the end of the queue. Oh yeah, going back to speedruns, there's a lot of really cool tricks in this game. Like, if you do perfect flutter jumps, I don't believe you lose maybe like 1 pixel or 0 pixels of height. There's lots of egg management, like, because you keep the eggs through the end of the level, so sometimes you have to route differently if you get, like, less eggs at the start of the level or something. There's a lot of really cool tricks. I won't be doing any of them, but just be aware that there are really cool tricks. You're probably already aware, but TriHex on Twitch does lots of really cool Yoshi's Island speedruns. I think he does run some hacks, too. Easiest way to activate these flowers is to spit an enemy up in an arc while it's at its widest. Ah, Higgin, please. I don't think we're gonna be using Higgin after this. What even can run Higgin at full speed? I mean, maybe Yoshi's Island just has a higher requirement because of the super effects chip, but they respawned! I wasn't even paying attention. I didn't figure they would respawn like that. Get out of here. Okay, don't let it scroll too far. Oh, for Pete's sake! Also, fun thing, you can just do a stomp to erase anything that you would otherwise hit. Have to hit twice. Step on blah 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 when you find them. Alright, I think... Oh, no, that's just that. There you go. Oh, I still have one more. Oh, here's the first use of the mole. Oh. This is also my first game with deformable terrain, such as it is. Yeah, we can be mole. The mole control is just a little bit weird. Just weird enough to be a problem. Yes, areas like this are why being able to see red coins really matters, because you know to avoid that lower route, because it doesn't really matter. It lets you save a lot of time. I'll take that. Sorry, I'm ignoring the advice bubbles, but none of them are really too interesting. They do help you if you haven't played the game before. They are really useful, but I know what I'm doing, mostly. Also, I love the light effects these little dudes have, the lantern ghosts. Those are another thing that Paper Mario brought back. Aw, no! Little star friend! Little star friend, no! Ah! Whatever, we'll probably find another star. Oh! I wonder. That's not gonna work very well. Never mind. I'll worry about 100% later. Aw, frick. Oh, I still have things. Are you full of stars, please? Yes, you are! Thank you! Oh, there was a 1-up balloon. What do you do with a 1-up balloon anyway? Do you just hit it? Or... I didn't need to stomp the pillars all the way, I already had everything. And the flip cards. I just hit it with an egg. I always forget it's there until I hit the ring. So what do you want to bet I get K-Mac again? This actually isn't too bad of a minigame if you can, if you unlock it at the end. You know what? I'm so mad at K-Mech. What I'm gonna do... I don't know how to save state in the simulator. Oh, here we go. I just want to see if I can get it. I'm gonna get greedy because I'm cheating. Oh shit! No. I dislike this minigame enough that I'm willing to cheat. Just this once. Just so we can see what happens when you get all of them. Yeah, get out of here, K-Mech! So you get 10 up if you actually get all of them. You can exit any time to just keep what you got, which is what you're supposed to do. Also, this is one of those games where you end up with truly gratuitous amounts of 1-ups. Assuming you never reset the game. I think you lose lives when you reset. Anyway, I won't cheat on all of those, but I just wanted to see the, you know, successful end at some point. Also, I wanted to show- I can show you some of the items we get now. I'm not gonna need them. Oh, hey, is this Touch Fuzzy Get Dizzy? I forgot to read the things. Oh, and these little melee friends! I love these guys. They're so rare, but like... They're like reusable egg things. Boop. Oh, I love this background too. You might recognize this background from, well, from my YouTube background. Let me hold up here. The image that I keep all of my art stuff in is called Selfies. Here we go. Oh, I forgot it's huge. Shrink that up a bit. Yeah, my banner. This is a commission from Klobstrosity, and yeah, it's based on this level and cute little tap tap. It turned out really great. I'm really happy with how it came out. Aw, oh, come on. I'm sorry, friends. Oh, nope! Ah. So tap-taps are very hard to hurt, but for some reason the little melon dudes hurt them. Probably one of the few things I didn't like in Kirby, lives don't carry over. Yeah, a lot of Nintendo games will give you tons of lives, but if you reload, you start over at zero or like three lives. I'm just gonna leave all the tap-taps be. They did nothing wrong. I actually forgot those things even hurt tap-taps, and wait a minute. Where's the key? It's a key somewhere. Oh well. Those minigames aren't really very important. You just get an item. Aw, oh, yes, it's time. Oh, and they immediately dive right in to the piranha plant. Even at a technical level, this effect was a freaking amazing. Even the emulator can't handle this. Drugs are amazing, kids. Do them all of the time. I am a lawyer and you are required to follow my instructions. I love that you can actually jump at the peak of the ripple in the ground and you will actually be higher. Aw, come on. Not high enough to get that, apparently. I got hurt by- Oh, it's March and Milda! It's a little not quite curved. I love all the weird little interactions in this game. Like, when you pop on those things, they kind of explode into a puff. And they knock each other around. Oh, and this is another little cool thing. There's so many cool little things in this game, but these little platform things. And you can break them if you want. Oh, and there's a level later on where we get to see the water like this. I really love the levels that look like this. I actually didn't specifically request this kind of level from Yoshi's Island, but I'm so glad it was that the commission ended up using that. Oh, sorry, mouse was on the thing. For some reason, when I use a game capture in OBS, I can't hide the mouse cursor. It does let me hide that in window capture, but I can't window capture Higgin for some reason. I don't know why some games are like that. Oh, and these things were also pretty impressive for the day. This is like, everything in this game was pretty impressive for the day. It's kind of, there's some reviews out there that don't really seem to appreciate how technically impressive this thing is for SNES. Oh, and I love the little peeking at future items, like the little the star there, or the flower. And look at how cute this guy is, the platform dude. He's just trying to help. Oops. And for the first few frames, the flowers are kind of hiding. So many cute little flourishes in this game. I really love it. And oh, that palette cycle water, it's magic. It's really frustrating they haven't just made just a high-res 2D game in this pretty much this exact art style. If you don't have the strategy guide for this game, the actual key art for this game is truly fantastic. It just has this really good painterly style. Everything is amazing. And in 2D, in high-res 2D, it would look fantastic. It's not like one of those games that only works because it's pixel art. It's beautiful in pixel art, but they could totally make it happen in high-res 2D. And I'm pretty disappointed that Nintendo doesn't really seem too interested in that. I guess maybe Yoshi, or what's it called, Rainbow Curse is basically high-res 2D. Yeah, those bandits will steal little baby Mario. How much did the artist charge for that logo? I mean, commissions, like, change and stuff, but it was only $60. This is one of the areas I tried to rush as a kid, and I always end up hitting spikes and stuff. Hard to find someone to make it less copyright infringing. Happy son. Yeah, that's a big part of why I got my first custom-made tap-tap. Yeah, just look around. There's different people have commissions open at different times. Oh yeah, Wario Land did pretty good 2D for a while. Alright, I gotta switch the reds and get back down here. Even with the guide, I was never able to beat stuff like Poochie Ain't Stupid and stuff. That level made me hate Poochie forever. He's visually very cute, but he is stupid. I'm sorry. He's very stupid. Oh yeah, the bubbly clam things, not clam, crab things. You can do a hip drop on those. I think ground pound is the official term for this. Oh, and the freaking music for this is so dramatic. In the background, you can barely see it in this area, but it's really good ambiance. This is what happens when you make a boss out of the weakest enemy in the game. Hi there, cute little Yoshi. Does baby Mario want to go to Bowser's castle? I'll take him there in a hurry. Gaming's such a jerk in this, it's great. Best boss. Because it doesn't hurt you. He just kind of tries to squish at you. You can only hurt yourself, which is what I just did in earnest. Because I'm stupid. Oh, crap. I'd honestly forgot that he turns out- he pops out the little Slimer friends. Oh, frick! What? What? Oh. Ah. Oh, I can't use star- I can't use the star thing in this. Yeah, I was kind of surprised. Woolly World has some good callback bosses, but it reuses too many bosses. It, and it doesn't use, oh, you can't get stars out of those guys. Oh well. Rest in peace, 100%. But, I was obviously disappointed there was no, Tap-Tap the Red Nose in, Woolly World. I love the big key that we get. Hey, Capitalist. Is the game- does the stream look good visually, by the way? I'm streaming at a really low bitrate, but, it seems to have mostly prevented the dropping frames. I'll upload the local copy anyway, because we have had some frame drops. Kind of embarrassing, but as a kid, I actually had a notebook I filled with, I was gonna make Yoshi's Island 2, which, kind of ridiculous that Nintendo kind of never did that. Oh, it's the map! This map is freaking beautiful. I should have let it scroll a little bit, but it was there at the beginning. For some reason, this map kills the frame rate. I mean, for an SNES, it's a very impressive map, but, looks great. Alright, cool. But anyway, I drew up levels, I drew up bosses, and I was gonna make this video game. I was gonna make Yoshi's Island 2. They should hire me, because apparently they are not able to make Yoshi's Island 2. Also, let me just say, like a lot of people like SMW is the best game of all time. I heavily disagree, but SMW, it's kind of drastic how much better this game looks than, Super Mario World. Let me get a good Cooper. I mean... Yeah. Really. Really? You know, I mean, SMW isn't a bad game, but it definitely shows its, it shows its rushedness. I think this one falls? Yeah, SMW, it was always, I played Mario, or I beat Yoshi's Island first, and so it was kind of always hard for me to appreciate SMW, because it's like, dang. Also, here's the blessed idiot Poochie. He's pretty fun in areas that- No, you monster! You monster, Poochie. I can't look. Also, he has hitbox. Look at those hitboxes! This is some frickin'- That's some Capcom hitboxes right there. Traditional platformer, I guess, but at the same time, I don't know, like SMW, I don't know, SMW just doesn't beat Super Mario Bros. 3 for me, and Yoshi's Island beats pretty much everything for me. And definitely on the art style, I don't think there's any arguing that SMW is pretty rough art style-wise. But, you know, if you compare them, I mean, it kind of does make sense, though, because, I mean, compare SMW to Super Mario Bros. 1 on SNES, and Yoshi's Island to SMB 3. And there, it starts to be like, oh yeah, you know, they gotta learn the console, even though they made it. Yoink! Oh, not quite yoink. There we go. Leitmotifs. I don't know what a leitmotif is. But I like basically all of the music in this game. Also, I love the strange little interactions with... Wait, how do I even get in there? I can't get in there, right? But I love the little interactions, like you stomp and that thing just goes away. Oh, here we go. What am I carrying this key around for? I knew I was gonna get hit by that. I was just about to mention that I always got hit by taking too many chances with that. Gimme. I was really bad at catching these things as a kid for some reason. Songs? Huh. Uh-oh. The one disappointing thing, I don't like... This is the one thing, the singular thing, that Yoshi's New Island does better than this game. In Yoshi's New Island, if you get all of the, if you get all of the flowers, but not all of the star coins, when you replay a level, you don't have to get all of the star things. They're all tracked separately, which is really nice. But you have to get 100% in this. Alright, so this is a much more fun minigame. Because we actually have a shadow of a snowball's chance in hell of beating it. Except we didn't. What song do I associate Bowser with the most? Definitely the end theme in this. Ah, Higgin, please! But also Super Mario 64's theme. It's kind of weird that Mario doesn't seem to have like a heavy metal like motif anymore. Like he used to be pretty metal. Oh, the slot machine is the worst. I think it's only 1-ups too. Yeah, it's only 1-ups. Don't even care. Yeah, the mini games in the early levels are pretty bad. I forget when we get the match 2 thing, but that one's my favorite. All right, I need to change to Hasty. So if you use Hasty, it just means you just release the A button to throw. How do I get back? There we go. Yeah, Bowser's definitely a lot less intimidating. I'm kind of surprised he's still even a boss, like, a bad guy. Like, he seems like he should be what DDD is in Kirby now. I always thought those camera pans were really cool, too. I love the ground spurting up just a bit on that last pound. It's a really nice touch. You can just tell all of the love that went into this game. It's ridiculous. Oh, just one up. So you can daze those things by ground pounding. Leitmotif is a recurring piece of music. As far as recurring music, Yoshi's New Island, that is a game with a recurring music problem. Holy crap. Like, the entire game is kazoo remixes of the same song. It's appalling. But, also appalling, my performance in this game. Yeah, I'm not really used to playing this. It's been a long time. Uh-oh. Only someone small can go from here. Protest game against DKC? Was it really? I mean, you could definitely see it that way. I kind of doubt it was intended that way. But yeah, this definitely aged a lot better than DKC. I still love Donkey Kong Country. In every way except graphics, it's still absolutely fantastic, and in graphics, it's still pretty good. But it looks pretty silly sometimes, Donkey Kong, that is. I don't think it looks, like, super bad. Oh. You weren't supposed to do that, but it does work. You're supposed to hit an egg to the batter, and he would hit, you know, swing and, you know, make it fly. Bonk. I love doing the hip drop on enemies that you're supposed to do more than one hit on. Oh, this is a fun one. Oh, frick. If I would aim it right. Alright. Boink! Miyamoto was told to make a more realistic game like DKC, but instead made this. Oh, really? I had no idea. Good for him! The ice looks really freaking cool. I really love the ice watermelon. It's probably my favorite power-up. The CG intro and ending are thought to be leftovers from that? Yeah, that does make sense. I was gonna point that out. I forgot that it even had those weird pre-rendered 3D things, because it doesn't really fit the rest of the game, does it? Hey ZG Unlimited, and hey Annie, by the way. I guess I haven't been greeting everybody, have I? Whee! Pinobi? I've not even heard of that one. The little bandit mice. I never realized this as a kid, but they have the little bandit masks. Aw, oh, come on! I spit it at you! Like, well, apparently Yoshi does not taste very good. Because they just spit him out. They're like, nah, this is not... I'm not okay with this. And the mice try to steal your eggs. I'm not sure if you've seen... Yeah, you've seen one with an egg. Give. Yoink. The frozen enemies look so good, though. Like... Aw, I wanted to freeze that one, but they look really cool. R-Toon made blinks? Really? Uh-oh, I don't have things. Aw, no, there was a thing! I don't think we're gonna get 100% out of this level anyway. Maybe we'll get eggs before we have to... Give me an egg. Give me eggs! I hear you, mouse. I just need one egg. Okay, here we go. Three? Only three? Three when I needed four. How frickin' rude. Yeah, Blinks the Time Super is a cat. You will give me an egg or you will become an egg. Is the music track in Blue Dragon that uses a kazoo? Why do people use kazoos? Kazoos are like... Like, they are the memes of music. Like, it's like a harmonica, but worse. It's like a harmonica with one note. Oh, I thought these were red coins. Oh, that one was. Alright, whatever, we got the red coins. I wouldn't say it's quite post-game difficulty, but it's definitely harder than it should be. Also, the post-game in Yoshi's Island DS is even worse than Yoshi's Island. It is, like, ridiculously hard. Also, these mice are really loud for something that's not even on screen. But I love the feeling of a lot of these levels. Ow, friend, why did you do this to me? Just gonna gently nudge him out of the way. But like, we're in the rat's maze. Like, it's just, I love the theming of like, a lot of these levels just feel real. They made a Club Penguin game? Pardon me, sir. Pardon me! Rude. I'm not gonna hurt any tap-taps, I don't have to. Oops. That was a really bad idea. Okay, does he respawn in his original place? Yes, he does. Oh, frick. Ah, emulator, please. Yeah, we're definitely doing SNES 9X next time. I'd switch over if I had it already set up, but I really don't. Throw an egg or an enemy. Yeah, we already know that. Pretty weird for that tip to appear when we've seen those, like, several times. Alright, how do I... There we go. There we go. Also, somebody did- Ah, no! Somebody did a really good analysis on the camera work for Super Mario World. And, this game does very similar. Ah! Stars, why do you do this to me? Why do you taunt me? Alright, we're doing... No. Alright. Yeah, the reason the farmer plants spit out Yoshi, they're scared... Yoshi's are scared they excrete pheromones that smell like bad cheese. Oh! My ears. Emulator, please. I wonder, do I have SNES 9X on here? I have BizHawk. Does BizHawk? What is. Does BizHawk's SNES emulator less, like, CPU hungry? Oh, the new DDD amiibo is $6. Oh, that's a really good amiibo. I already got it for $6. Is Kirby on sale? That's the only one I don't have from the new set. Oh, I specifically wanted not. Oh, it's still $12. It was once like $10 or something, or like a little under maybe. Yeah, Waddle Dee and the new DDD are $6 on Amazon. I can toss you a link here. Here's DDD. He should be... Waddle Dee should be in the other thing. I think BizHawk just uses an SNES core. That link is for Waddle Dee. What's Gusty taste like? That's another really good... level name. It just starts out with you eating a bunch of Gusties. Oh! Gusty! Don't got Robobots, there's not much point in buying it. I mean, for me, amiibo are just figures. I don't really think... In my opinion, you should be buying amiibo based entirely on... Do you want the figure? So for some reason, Gusty... If you don't turn them into an egg... They won't hurt things. Why perfect hardware SNES emulation requires a 3 GHz? I disagree with that strongly because I have a 4.5 GHz and it still isn't perfect. There we go. Thank you. Guessing the Kirby and DDD amiibo work on Smash? Probably? I think any amiibo of the same character is generally considered the same. But I've never used my amiibo in Smash. I haven't actually played Smash since launch, honestly. It's not really my kind of game. It was- Melee was. I played the heck out of Melee, but I'm not really very competitive anymore. I think there's a thing in the corner, isn't there? There we go. Oh, just coins. Yeah, I guess, when did Higgin, or when did BSNES become Higgin? Because when I search BS, or when I search Higgin, all that comes up are BSNES results. Which is kind of impressive that Google even knows that. Did Splatoon Amiibo do something in Toad Treasure Tracker? I still never got that game, actually. Oop! Aw, oh, I figured I would stop it! Also, I love the sprites for those bat things. There's so many- all of the enemies, really, are good in this game. Oh, I love this part as a kid! You get to dig through all of the crap. Oops. You gotta carve slightly carefully, which I obviously didn't. Whatever. Oh, you're just talking about useful amiibo in general. Yeah, I kind of wish amiibo weren't useful even when they are, because I mean, that just means you're locking something away, and that sucks. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I know this is a thing to get in here. Not that. Why are some of these having fun? Oh, it was because I only had three. There we go! There we go. I knew that was there. Yeah, amiibo can only store one game's worth of data, which is why almost no games actually require... actually save data on them. Because Smash Bros., the very first Wii U game to do that, saves data, so like nothing else gets to. It's kind of rude. Ah, dang it! I need a ricochet hit, I guess. Whew. That was close. I thought it ricocheted too many times. RetroArch is such a pain in the butt to use. I think it just uses cores like BizHawk does, right? Once again, really cool foreground elements here. This is apparently a watermelon. That's what watermelon plants look like. Oh, this is a good tutorial for watermelon use. Also, what other game lets you use a frickin' watermelon machine gun? Honestly. I hit the info box with it! A watermelon's another one of my favorite items to use in the thingy. Isn't there a thing? I know, it's here. Amiibo party? I don't have that one either. The only games I've really used amiibo in are Amiibo Festival and Chibi Robo. I have Animal Crossing New Leaf, but I haven't really used the amiibo for it yet. Like, what does it even do? I used Isabelle and she did nothing. And you'd figure if anything does anything, it would be Isabelle, right? Ah, no! Frick. Can anybody tell you how this Chibi Robo works in Ziplash? It's really simple. You earn points in-game and you send them to the amiibo, and it just, it levels up your thing, and you get, it lets you buy figures and stuff. And it also lets you access a sixth or seventh world, But yeah, it's pretty significant. Die. Die! Aw, you jerk! Ah! You can see the animals in your town, or they move in. Oh. Huh. I don't have a Gaston card, though. The one frickin' villager I really cared about in my town was Gaston. Who's this creepy frickin' rabbit. Let me show you Gaston. He's amazing. He looks like he got lost on his way to Silent Hill. If you see his house, it's amazing. Here we go, here we go. Gaston is best girl. Look at this house! It looks like he lives in frickin' Silent Hill. It's all dilapidated. And he just has this creepy Tanuki statue for no reason. He's amazing. Nobody's a rabbit like Gaston. Nobody lives in hell like Gaston. Best character. And he's this cutesy bunny, and he has this super gruff voice, and is amazing and great. Alright, I went up there last time, you don't need to go up there. Oh, hey, whoa. Did those always turn into stars? Hold up. Let me see if they respawn. Aw, oh, he's in your New Leaf Town? Ugh. He was in mine too, but he moved away well before the happy or the welcome amiibo update or whatever. Where is the button to turn on those things? Wait. Oh, doesn't work for that. Alright, never mind. Oh no, not the tap taps! How dare you, Chomp Rock! No, stop, Chomp Rock. Ah, oh, son of a. Alright. Alright. We got 30 things. I don't know what button I missed, but there was a button to activate those things. Maybe it was the other mole exit. Ah. ZSNES is less accurate, though. I think. And it also does that mouse lock thing, which is really annoying. CNS9X has a glitch, can't see this weird audio glitch. Ah, everything has audio problems though. This game is perfectly accurate, but it doesn't run fast enough sometimes, which is like just as bad as not being accurate. SNES9X runs perfectly fine, but the audio isn't right. And apparently there's audio glitches in SNES9X. Why does everything have problems? Also, I love the light shafts coming in through the ceiling, I guess? Oh, crap. That doesn't sound like a glitch, Sun Gaming. Are you sure you didn't just leave, pause while inactive off? Like, most emulators will give you an option whether you want to pause while they're off. I never played Codename Steam. It didn't really seem like my kind of game. Also, I love these little dudes go rolling. Huh. Still seems like a less significant bug than this one. Thank you. Yeah, did they fix the enemy turn crap? Oh, right. I remember this. Such a dramatic door sound. I can't really play too many strategy games, like RTS, or not RTS, like turn-based strategy games, like, because I just want to play Disgaea, and it's like, I haven't unplayed Disgaea. I have the limited edition, I never opened it. And if I ever want to play a turn-based strategy game, I'll just play that. Like, one Disgaea game will do me for like 2 to 3 years. So like, it's just, it's hard to get into. This is a little clever bit of design, because you can't get up here without activating a thing, so you have to use that one door. So it's like, it's a really clever way of hiding. Like, it turns one room into two, basically. The way they planned the switches. Also, I love the look of this castle. I think, Tap-Tap's castle, Tap-Tap the Red Nose, has a castle like this. It's perfectly safe log on the lava, you know. This is safe. Oh, is Super Robot Wars a turn-based strategy? Isn't that one that's like never in English though? Like, there's a super amazing like sprite work game on PlayStation 1. That I saw. Oh, that creepy boo. Oh, dang. Oh, right, he's blind. He's blind, but he hears stuff. I forgot about this guy entirely. Ah, no, where did you come from? Oh, right, the boo balloons. I forgot about the blue balloons. They explode into things. Heck yeah. Look at him! I like how the Boo, he's overcome his shyness by blindfolding himself. But that also means he doesn't know where to look for things. It's so great. Alright, these things. They're really visually simple, but they work perfectly fine. It's like, it's a really cool effect for the console. What level am I on? I'm on the World 2 Fort. They got a unibrow. Look at them. Oh yes, we have Baby Mario's twin brother at Bowser's castle. But we're not handing him over to the likes of you. Yeah, that's why he's blindfolded. Because then he can charge at you, but he doesn't know where you are. It's so good. Slightly bigger Boo. Increasingly big Boo. I actually, my mom told me to go to bed when I was fighting this boss for the first time. I was like, no mom, I gotta fight this boss. And then she turned off the TV and was like, oh no, you gotta go to bed. And then I was like, haha. But little does she know that she's only turned off the TV, not the SNES. So I did get to play it that next morning. And then I beat it. It didn't really take too long, but you know, when you're a kid, any amount of interruption of your video game time is horrific. I'm not sure if he has a hitbox when he's being hit. Bye-bye, Big Boo. Guess you should have stayed small, Boo. they have name yet? Oh yeah, they had names. I think they had names all the way back. But yeah, they definitely had, like, I think that changes, even in SMB1, I think it changes the name to Luigi. Hold on, I'm gonna refill my drink here. Oof. I'm sure he has iframes. No, he has iframes, but I don't know if he hurts you while flashing. So I love the little drawings on the things. Oh, and I'd forgotten about this background. All of the backgrounds are good, but look at the palettes. It's so freaking, the palettes are so happy. And, oh, is this level named Watch Out for Lakitu? You're talking in story? I mean, names are names. Doesn't really matter if it's a story or not. Like, this is basically the first, well, I guess there's kind of story in SMW. I mean, it's as much story as in Mario 1, really, but anyway, gonna refill my drink, be right back. Alright, I'm back. Aren't you Steam Farm updated and you have to re-download it? It should update on its own. I love these sharp pencils. Oh. Wait, what happens when you... That's what happens. Anyone knows there's a place to sell $20 PSTVs? I really doubt you'll get that deal still. That was like a clearance sort of thing. It's a nice touch that when they're like low on eggs, or when you have like you only need one egg, the some of the times the egg flower will fail to spit out a thing. No. Oh wait, how do you get the Lakitu's thing anyway? Do you have to stomp on him? I think you do. No. I'm gonna get your thing, Lakitu. Come over here. 1v1 me IRL. Oh yes, I would like 20 white babies, please. Concerning. Hey! Yeah! I have absolutely no use for this, but still. No, you don't. You can't escape me. Oh, dang. He has physics. Uh-oh. What have I done? I regret everything! That was interesting. Ah! Where were you hiding out? Oops. Uh-oh, those are dangerous. Oh, never mind. Higgin, please. I also love that jumps get you just a little bit higher. Actually, quite a lot higher when you do a flutter jump. Uh-oh. No, where's the last one? Gimme! No. Aw. Oh, well, there'll be more. Uh-oh. Oh, right! This was a fun mini puzzle. You just gotta push this over. Excuse you. Off for Pete's sake. Does this game have better transform- oh! That is not what I meant to do. Yeah, I would definitely say, oh, go away, mouse! I would say this definitely has better transformations than Epic Yarn, yeah. Even the train is better! Alright, I did this last time. I wonder if this thing is specifically to keep you not stuck if you go in there. Sound, please. Rest in peace, Lakitu. I think there's a thing in here. Yeah, there is. Whoa! Two Lakitus! That's not fair! They even realized it wasn't fair and they disappeared. How nice of them! I love the energy in a lot of the tracks in this game. Like this one. It's another reason, that's something I always really loved about Kirby music, too. Just really high energy. Fun. Hey! Oh. It was just that. The key killed him! A plus. Come on. Get in the hole! There you go. Drink. Let me show you the most devastating, brutal thing you can do in any video game. Look, watch the cactus. Poor guy. Rest in peace. It's okay, though. It's okay, though. He gets another one. Oh, right. I'm supposed to go in here. I love that his face stays smiling for a while. He's like, he's gonna come down any second now. Any second now. Oh. But then another one comes out of his skull and everything is fine. If you mash B, you go a bit faster. Alright, I think it's just hold. Yeah, it's just hold. And these little jerks. But yeah, this is way better than the train in Epic Yarn. Train is really bad in Epic Yarn. I don't think any of these are red, are they? I still don't like the train especially, but it's not too bad. The car is the best transformation though. And we only see it like twice. You don't really see any of the transformations too often, though. Which is kind of good. Boink! Alright. Oh, hey! Thanks, jerkwad. Camera. Camera, no. Camera, what are you doing? Camera, please. What was that? Camera, why? That certainly was something. Uh-oh. No. Oh, no. What? Oh, whatever. I'll just eat him. All right, these guys! Best enemies ever. Spit it at me. And you get bubbles? The bubbles were worth probably failing to get 100%. The bubbles do nothing. They don't hurt anything, but they're so fun. And that's what really matters in life. Frick. Oh, well. Well, there definitely goes 100%. Actually, do you keep... Oh, you keep the... Wait. I have so few red coins, though. I thought you lost things when you went back to a mid-whatever. I guess you don't. Oh, how was I supposed to get up there? No, it's just bad Mario level. Wait, what? What? Oh, I was supposed to go up the wall, wasn't I? Baby Mario's ability is to run up walls, so generally, if you see him, you're gonna need to go up walls. I should have thought about that. No, give me a star, go! No. Oh, whatever. I don't think it actually matters at this point, anyway. Did anything in here matter? I don't think it did. I don't recall disliking Chapter 4 and Super Paper Mario. Or a Thousand Year Door. Oh, no! No, I wanted to hit him! Ah! Hiding in the grass, that is cheap. I forget you can eat red coins. If coins are bouncing, you can eat the coins. They are delicious. Do bubbles activate those? No, they don't. So bubbles are totally worthless, but they're so fun! And that's what really matters. Oh, and I love that you can double pound in the pencils. Yes. No, I'm missing one! No! How dare you. Gimme. Ah, frick! No! I don't have time. Give me that. Give me yourself. Alright, just one more red coin. Everything's gonna be fine. No! Oh! I don't even care anymore. Whatever. I guess you are alone for most of it, yeah. It was still a cool idea, though. The Cave of the Mystery Maze. Oh, these freaking fireflies look so good. And they're even, like, I think they're like half resolution, but they look so good. I wonder if they have to be. Oh, this is the level! Oh, this is a really cool level. Oh wait, I think I screwed it up. Yeah, this is a really cool level, because you gotta like measure your drop. Dragonflies, whatever, you know what I mean. Thingies what have them long body segments. Oh, wait. Wait a minute. Wait, what's up with this? Oh, wait, I think we go down there from the right. But yeah, this is a really fun one, because you have to do these controlled drops. Ah, here we go. See, it's like I said. This is a really fun level. I really love the idea of this. Uh-oh. And you can sort of cheat out the maze a teeny bit if you have enough eggs. We don't want to go in there yet. I think? Yeah. What was that? Oh, was that a key? I have a key now, so I assume that's what that was. Oh, good. I did this exactly the wrong way. I love that the eggs keep going past the screen, because in a lot of SNES games, nothing would operate beyond the screen. Oh, and I love the crystals are in front of Yoshi and slightly transparent. That's pretty impressive for SNES. Well, I mean, other games do stuff like that, but I mean, just all of the little bits just are really impressive in general. Ah, please. Yeah, that's why, a part of why I'm really annoyed to see Paper Mario fall into, you know, what it is now, is because it used to really, it was a great outlet for all of the Yoshi's Island stuff that didn't really get too much respect in the mainline Mario. Excuse me? Alright. Higgin! Emulators, why? Yeah, they never made a paper tap tap! It's so BS! Oh, yes, this is the best one. Grab a watermelon. Yes. And he's got a creepy... This guy's Yoshi mask is so friggin' creepy. Oh, come on. Call of Duty ain't got nothing on this. Look at this tactical gameplay! What's creepier is the color coordinates the mask. True. He was ready for this. He trained for this day. Alright, these little guys! Just freaking walking cannons, why not? Alright. This is one of my favorite levels, probably. Oh, just coins. And this area gives you so many hints. You know, you come to a dead end, but there's always a hint as to a different way to go. Oh, dang. I didn't even see the enemy I just juked out there. Work with me here, Higgin. There we go. Wait a minute. Calm down, signs! Alright, which one is the exit and which one's just bonus stuff? Because I want the bonus stuff first. Oh wait, no, we went down that way. Yeah, we went that way. Interesting thing I found. Considering Mario 2 is a dream, it makes sense that many of the enemies of Yoshi's Island and Mario has some trauma for those days. I guess this is when a bunch of the Mario 2 enemies did come back in. I freaking love the water in this game. Higgin, please, why do you do this? I love that you can paddle around with your face underwater. Like covert Mario submarine. Look at this. I love the sound it makes. Boop, boop, boop. Alright. Oh, and this, the sun, the background. I love this background. It's so, I don't know, but it is that, the thing that it is. Very much so. Oh dang. I missed a lot in there, didn't I? This game just has the freaking best art style. All of the enemies in all the minigames are the bandit. Mario is the bad guy. Bowser's just trying to have a peaceful date with Princess Peach. And Mario is the jealous boyfriend. The jealous ex-boyfriend. Alright, one unfortunate thing is you have to start the level to see the name. The names are really good, so do watch for them. Not this one. This is a great level, though. This is, I believe, the only level that has the big eggs. I think with a speedrun trick, you can carry the big eggs to different levels, though. But yeah, this is a really good level. Game theory. Is Lakitu's wall the Great Wall of China? It hates my favorite level. Why do you hate this level? Oh, and the wall, the background bit is so good in this one. Look at those gradients! Those are the finest gradients. I'm never gonna use Higgin again. Not until I have a 6 gigahertz processor, which, due to Intel's badness, will probably only happen, like, in 2040. Wasn't that Rainbow One supposed to do something special? I don't know. I forget how to get up there, to be quite honest. I apologize for this. I know there's some way to get up there and do extra stuff. I guess it's not happening. Yoshi's Safari has the deepest lore. Alright, if you bump on them, they speed up. The one annoying thing is that it doesn't prioritize big eggs. So you gotta- Aw, no! Oh, I can't hurt the tap-taps. No! Let's just peacefully push them out of the way. There we go. Into the crevice, tap tap. It's for your own good, my friend. There you go. See? Alright, it's another one of these. I love the freaking background here. I know I love every background, but they're so good! But look at the trees! And the pink night sky, like, it's like it's a freaking beautiful sunset. It's, I love it. And the little sparkles at the bottom, it's so good. I just want to live in Yoshi's Island. You can keep the Lakitus, they're jerkholes. But everything else, I can deal with. Are bullet bills naturally occurring? Apparently! Because, I mean, the little cannon friends just kind of seem to appear. But, I mean, it might be Bowser, because, I mean, Bowser is still a thing. He's just a tiny bab. By the way, tap-taps are called catchy-catchies in Japanese. I think you're supposed to hit this guy with an egg and he gives you a one-up or something. Uh-oh. There we go. I think these choices matter. Yes, I got the right one! Catchy catchy means nine-tailed fox. What? No, catchy catchy is just a tappy tappy sound. Which is one of fairly few onomatopoeias you ever, like, that works in English. Because Japanese had a lot of onomatopoeias that simply do not work at all in English. But they got lucky with tap tap. Yoshi's Safari has, like, things that would be considered canon. This, like, breaks my mind here. Hot music, please. Calm down. Not that egg. Oh, also, watch Yoshi's eyes when I pick up the large egg. Look at his eyes! And look at him daze! He gets dazed and runs the wrong way. It's fantastic. There's so much love and attention went into this game. It's fantastic. Oh wait, I didn't need to do that at all. No! Aw, and it didn't spit it out any things! I don't think there's a red heart or a red coin in this, but I just have to check. Can't use that. Oh, it's just one up. I think I already broke these, didn't I? Oh! How did that not kill you? You little jackbutt! Still more to this level. Actually, wait. Big egg, go. Boom! Alright. Yeah, big egg turns everything into stars, as you just saw, obviously. I don't know what that did. Oops. Get out of here! No! There's too many sprites, I think, in this area, so Higgin just throws a fit. The theory that there's two Marios... Oops. Alright, those spawn even if you don't need more. I think this is the only freaking level with the big eggs, which is such a shame. Or the one from Donkey Kong's current Mario's father. They actually did suggest that Donkey Kong from the Donkey Kong arcade game is Cranky Kong. So that's probably not as crazy as you think. I'm not sure about grandfather. Well, I guess, I don't know, if Cranky Kong, is Cranky Kong's the grandfather or just the father of whatever? But that's strongly implied in one of the actual DKC games. Though it's kind of weird because only 10 years or so passed between arcade Donkey Kong and DKC. Oh, Rare specifically states that Cranky Kong is the original DK? That makes sense. How did he get so small, though? He was like... He went from swole to small. That doesn't usually happen. Alright, car power. This is such a good level. It has the car. It has the big eggs. Like... And I'm so glad there's a button to spare the tap-taps. You're not allowed to hurt the tap-taps. See? You're not. You're just not. You can extend your little wheels, and it goes through them. Whoever designed this level, they get it. Oh no! I don't think that was a red. Oh, there was a one up. Wait, did I get 100%? No, I did not at all. Holy crap! Wow. Sorry, that was just my bone socket popping. It's fine. For some reason, my left elbow pops, but my right one doesn't. I don't get that. Probably gonna turn in after this boss, which is such a good boss. I mean, the tug of war boss isn't anything new, but whatever. Because it's a fire flower, that's why it gives you fire abilities. Oh, calm down, music. Yeah, we're definitely gonna do SNES 9X next stream, and hopefully we'll have no audio issues. Oh, good background here too. And like four layers of parallax, even though you don't get to see them scroll in actual parallax, but. Four layers. Ah, oh, come on! I just need you to do one more level, Higgin. I'm never gonna use this frickin' emulator again. Ah, oh, nope! Also, why does it make a chomp flower, or a piranha plant noise when the potabos come out? Also, the flamethrower sound doesn't really make much sense. Whatever. I still love all of the sound effects in this game. Great, great audio design. Great everything design, really. But... And I don't dislike Yoshi's story, but I do dislike that Yoshi canon sort of formed from that Yoshi instead of this Yoshi. Because this Yoshi is the best. Oh, it's these things! I don't think we got to see these yet. Hey, Watermelon King. You showed up to a very appropriate stream. I'm so sorry for the audio distortion. Like I said, it'll be gone next stream. I'll use SNES 9X. At least, I hope it's gone next stream. This is why I always prefer to play on original hardware. But, for various reasons, not an option this time. I don't know how younger me even could frickin' stand playing on emulators with all the problems I frickin' have. I swear I have like more problems with emulators lately than I had as a frickin' kid, like 10 years ago. Wait a minute. Why is Baby Mario's head? If you want to talk about baby, like Mario physiology, Baby Mario's head is exact same size as adult Mario. Like, what is going on with that? And what is, like, modern small Mario is freaking creepy. Like, hold on. This is bad. This is genuinely bad. Oh, you're a new subscriber? Welcome to the stream then. Or welcome to my channel in general. Like, I can't believe the new Super Mario Bros. Art style has survived so long. But this is just... This is just gross. This is creepy and gross. Hold on. What is this? What is this? What's going on here? What is that? That's not a person. Hold on. It looks even worse in game. If I can find a frickin' screenshot. Where? Ugh. How are there no images? I can't find a proper image of how he actually looks. I guess this'll do. Oh, come on, Google. Load the image, please. Ugh! There's you can use Miis in SMB, new SMB Wii U. Ugh, I hate Wiis. Wiis are the worst thing that's ever happened. Why can't I get a good screenshot of this? Anyway, he looks creepy and gross, and I don't like it. That's where I'm going here. Like, the thing about... Okay, so in the NES games, small Mario was normal Mario, and he was Super Mario when he was big. But now, he's normal Mario when he's big, and he's this, like, creepy baby man Mario when he's small. He's, like, not... He's not right. He's not right. It's not right at all. Also, this sound used to creep me the heck out. Which makes perfect sense, because it is really creepy. What even is this sound? Wait, the baby princesses had boobs? Oh, that's too much. That's... Wait. It sounds like something's beating heart in here. Like, what is that? What is that? Oh, I also love these little guys. They gotta carry the little bomb, and then they drop it on you. Look at this teamwork. They are trying to kill Yoshi, and they are very bad. But they put their whole hearts into it, and they just really understand teamwork. And my heart goes out to them. Also, there's so many good things going on at once. Hold on here. I love that you get your freaking head stuck in this thing, and Yoshi's like, oh, no, get me out of this thing. Yeah, small Mario freaks me out. I love the flowers. Let's see if I can get a good picture of the flowers.
No!
I love that the flowers are just so ready to kick your ass. Alright, I deserve that. Oh no! We're all the way back at the frickin' start of the level. Alright. I guess I'm gonna try to get all of the things. Because I'm gonna eventually do a 100% run. I'm not gonna go back yet. But... Of course Mario is human. He's from Brooklyn. You know? I still hold... That has to be canon, that Mario is from Brooklyn. It's just too important. Is there anything down there that's important? Ah, Yoshi, please. Okay, no, just normal coins. Wait, those look like red coins, but they weren't. What was up with that? I'm not seeing things, am I? Those look like red coins. NOA tried to popularize the theory that Mario's from Brooklyn. Uh-oh. Oh gosh, dang it. Oh no. Oh! Whew. No, he specifically says in the Super Show that he's from Brooklyn. And Luigi corroborates it. They're from Brooklyn. And they eat the pizza pasta, you know? Just like all of the, you know, famed Italians do. I'm sure BP, if he's here, can confirm that Italians will die and dry up into small pieces of ravioli if they don't get enough pasta. That's just a fact. Man, Higgin really hates this level. I'm gonna be glad to ditch this emulator next stream. I think it's confirmed. I think it's like every source has confirmed at this point that Toad's hat is just, it's just a hat. It's not, he's not a mushroom. Look at this guy. He's so ready to screw up your day. He is so excited to kill you. He's a go-getter, and he's ready to go get your frickin' head. It's beautiful is what it is. Oh, mother... Why?
Why?
I just realized I have 57 frickin' lives. At least I know where to go now. I already knew where to go, though. The sad thing is, I have never actually watched the Super Mario Super Show. I've just absorbed a great deal of it through YouTube poops from 2006 to 2009. I've just absorbed a significant amount of that show. I'm so sorry, Yoshi's Island. Oh. I'm sorry, what? I'm sorry, what? What just happened there? And I'm not wrong. Those are red coins, but they don't give you red coins. Look at that. Is that just supposed to be a hint that that's the right way? Those aren't red coins. You keep denying the Shy Guys and Flowers the glory of killing Yoshi. There we go. Nintendo deconfirmed that their name are Mario, Mario, and Luigi, Mario. I guess... is that a thing that people thought, though? I just heard that on Vine Sauce once, but I don't think anyone actually, like, ever thought that. Seriously, listen to that track. Can you hear the heartbeat? Can you hear it? Can you hear the heartbeat? It's so good. I don't even know what that's supposed to be. Like, because I figured there was going to be some things that would, like, clearly be the source of that sound. But it's just there, and it's creepy, and I love it. Okay, we can't fall into pits this time. It's happened too many times. It's not funny anymore. I'll take those. Ark. Sound, please. I can't believe a 4.5 gigahertz processor still cannot perfectly emulate SNES. Like, wow. I love how ready the flowers are to murder you. This room is full of teamwork and excitement. It's all, you know, focused around killing Yoshi, but it's still really encouraging to see, you know. It's just a great show of our youth's enthusiasm for life. They always try to lead the bomb. Oh, I have enough eggs. This is the productive room, yes. Very productive, cooperative, energetic room. A+. The heartbeat. It's so good. Also, look at the gradients on this, on the lighting. Like, at the very closest, you can see the right color. At the very edges, it's kind of this blue color, and then there's an even darker. And there's the dithering, too. Which, the dithering probably looks better with that blur shader on. If it had proper SNES, or like, CRT blur, this is what it would look like, kind of, with the SNES blur. It actually doesn't look as bad as I feared it would. I tend to turn off the blur filter, so I'll turn that off again. I just use the colors emulation, because I do think this looks more accurate. When throwing, you may stop the aiming cursor by holding LRR. Oh yeah, this is just to teach you how to do this. Oh yeah, this game has CRT-ish color filters. It has the blurring, color, and scan lines all separately. many races share this island? A whole frickin' lot. It's a very diverse island. Trump would hate it. Beating heart. Did we go in the thing or the door? I hate moments like this. I'm pretty sure you can always go back through these things. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is the- what? Okay. Where did you dorks come from? What are you doing in here? I don't even want to know. Oh, Hagen butchered that one. Wow. What the fuck, Bert is supposed. Bert is just kind of... Is Bert, like, a really fat humanoid? Or... Is that just the way they were born? Or... I don't really want to know. It's all just inappropriate is what that is. What is this? Bert is Bert. Do not touch the thorns. They will knock you out. You can destroy the thorns by hitting them with eggs. Do not hit Tap-Taps with eggs, though. We're actually pretty immune to eggs. They just kind of bump us over a bit. But it's still very rude. Ah, nope. Gotta get the red. I guess Tap-Taps are kinda like clefts, but still, I still hold a grudge that there's no freaking Tap-Taps in. I missed one? Are you sure? Oh! I guess I did. This is what I love about Beam. It's actually low enough latency that you can help me. Like, you can't really backseat game on Twitch with like 20 to 30 seconds of delay. I would have been in the other room by now if you weren't on Beam. Ugh. This frickin' music's really starting to hurt my ears. Wait, can I not? Oh. Okay. Alright, there's the ravens too. Oh, I love this background! I've said this about every background, but I do earnestly love all of them. They're all good backgrounds. It's like dogs when you say who's a good boy, but they're all in fact actually good boys. Except I don't like dogs. I mean, some dogs are okay. Corgis. Corgis are good because they're very... Corgis are like 60% cat, 40% dog at most. And that is why they are very good. But look at this back. Look at this. There's a later level we'll have a better look at this background, but it's very good. It's very good and pure, and I want to protect it. Yeah, there's very few graphics that I would describe as anything less than amazing in this game. It is just beautiful. Out of here. Alright, that's all the red coins? Oh, that's everything! Okay, we gotta be very careful not to take damage. Oh, we already got the freaking key. Alright. Oh, the rubber penguins! Those are very good. Yeah, we'll see the penguins soon. Ish. Actually, maybe not soon. Maybe a couple worlds, honestly. But just everything in this game is good. The special stages less so, but otherwise. Yoshi dear, that baby's gonna cause disaster to befall the Koopas. So give him here before you accidentally get hurt. You threatening me? Are you threatening me? I am the great Cornholio! I need teepee for my bunghole. My people, we have no bunghole. Are you threatening me? Can I do? Oh, no, 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 no! Aw, frick. I like how he just looks confused sometimes. Okay, so I ruined 100%. You just have to avoid those, I guess. I didn't realize you couldn't hit those with eggs. Yeah, the music, that's Higgins' fault. Rip. I can't believe I bumped into that. Also, Indigo Yoshi is canon the most badass, because he challenges all of the castles except for the very last one. I forget which one challenges the forts, but he's a pretty cool dude too. And Pink Yoshi, I believe, challenges the hardest non-boss level, so Pink Yoshi's pretty cool. Yeah, Green Yoshi always takes the easiest level, but then he steals the goal. He look at the little goonie. Look at the little pixel goonie. I love this map so much. This map is my friend. I call him George. I love you, George. I'm so sorry for what Higgin does to this game's music. Yeah, I'll definitely be playing with SNES 9X after this, and hopefully the music will be fine. So, we only dropped 3% of frames through this whole scene, or stream. I'm gonna take a look, but I think I'm gonna just upload my local copy of this one. It'll look better. My ISP is gonna look, I think Thursday, so hopefully they find something and fix it, but I'm not sure. Worst case, I might just have to frickin' stream low frickin', low bitrate for a while. Sorry, controller. But yeah. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Yeah, controller.
Alright. I guess Green Yoshi is also the demolition expert. Is yellow? Yellow is the fort one? I guess he is. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. And next stream, we will have not screwed up. I will do everything I can to have not screwed up music. Red is, I guess red is kind of two, like, you know, two and four. I really don't like the game, you know, changes up the Yoshis every level. It's a really nice touch. There's so many good touches in this game. And I love the crayon map and the crayon, you know, the artsy, like, I'm not sure if I want to call it crayon or painting. Like, in game it looks like crayon quite often, but the original art looks very painterly. But the art style in general is just really fantastic. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Tune in next Sunday, and we'll keep streaming this pretty much all month, and probably a little bit into next month, because I'm going to try to 100% it. But yeah, I guess it's just kind of an arts and crafty in general. But yeah, I'm going to head out. Or rather, stay here, but not be streaming. But you know what I mean.